gathered round your grave to greet. Wish I could see
angelic tones, but do not have love. I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. I have a gift of prophecy and understand all the mysteries and all knowledge. If I have all faith so that I can move mountains, but I do not have love, then I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, if I give over my body, thank you. knowledge, it will come to an end. We know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when the perfect comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child. I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put aside childish things. For now we see only reflection, as in a mirror, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I will know fully, as I am fully known. Now these things remain, faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. Now, that's probably not your typical scripture for this type of service, but I think it's fitting, and the message that God has given me for the family is it fits right in. And actually, the scripture was for you. It was for us as family, as friends, to know that that's the way we've got to stay. We've got to stay humble, kind, love, speak to each other, kindness. God's given me a message, and if you could say it's my funeral message, I've spoken of this several times. It's about our relationship, because it's all we have here on this earth. You look around, you see nice cars, nice houses, but really all we have are our relationships, and that's what matters most. And I was reminded of a poem that I read and I've heard read before, but I'm not going to read the whole thing, but I will share some excerpts from it. It's called The Dash. On our headstones, there's a born date, and there's our heavenly birthday. But in the middle, where the dash is, that's the impact we make on this earth. That's how we make our mark here. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the dash. And the poem was written from a setting similar as this, a funeral service. And parts of it, what I want to share with you is that the dash represents all the time that she spent alive on earth. And now only those who loved her know what that little line is worth. For it matters not how much we own, how cars we have, houses we have, that doesn't matter. What matters is how we live, how we love, and how we spend our dash. That's part of it. I'm a firm believer that Wanda Ann, she's already preached her service. She's lived her life, and she's preached. She's loved, she's lived, and just like to share a little bit of what I remember about her. Coming over with, you know, especially with family reunions, the HIT reunion, which is non-existent now, but you know, when Lisa and I first started dating, I was in awe of, you know, the HIT reunion, how many people came, and how many, you know, you got your own shelter. Families have their own shelter to do their, you know, family reunions in. I'm like, this is just way cool. There was a bond there. You know, some people would come every year, every other year, but it was still a way to unite the family. And but if I can was not quiet when Wanda Ann came in. And her and Judy got together, and it was, you know, Otis always went in the other room because it was so, the conversation was so loud. I remember her being quiet in the conversation. Somewhat of a rebel, if you will. Just kind of making her own pathway, doing her own thing, and I'm not saying that in a negative sense. Saying that, and when I was thinking about this, I was reminded that, you know, Peter was picked as a disciple because of his rebellious spirit, the way he spoke out, the way he rolling up her pants legs and running off with no shoes through the daisies. And, you know, that's just kind of the picture I got. And, relationships are twofold. Being at the family reunion, our relationships, one we talk about that are horizontal, that go me and you and our family. And I'll say there's under that would be family, getting back with our family. The second one I would say just friends and close relationship. I think we've all got some relationships that are tainted, that need to be mended. And I challenge you today to, and I just pray the Lord put somebody on your mind that we can mend those fences with, that we can make the relationship right again. Because it's all that we have here. Everything you see around you, just look around. Everything's going to burn today. It's going to be ashes, and it's going to be nothing. But our relationships are what matter. It's what carries us through. It's what gets us through. It's what gets us through this hard time. It's our relationship. Start to mend our horizontal relationships. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 8, it says, above all, love each other deeply. Because love covers. Mercy covers us when we fail each other. But you step in and you cover. God, help us to do our part to recover those relationships. Challenge each and every one of us today to do that. Second part, not just vertically but horizontally, our relationship with the Father. Where do you stand today? Where's your relationship with Jesus? Are you reading, praying, and talking to Him every single day? How do you stand in His presence? Because one day, you know, I said one day and just preached her funeral, but she's the only one right now that knows, you know, her destination. And I believe it's with the Father, but the only ones that can say that right now is her. She's lived her life. She's had it. Had it to live, she lived it to the fullest. And I pray right now that if you're not in a right relationship with our Father, that you get right with Him today. He's calling you. He's just begging you to come and be a part. You know, He sent His Son to die for us, which is the greatest part of the relationship. And He gave His best. Somebody to talk with about your relationship, be glad to. Right now, relationship. Right. people in our lives like we've never loved them before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special dash might only last for just a little while. So when your eulogy is being read with your life's actions to rehash, would you be proud of the things they say about how you spent your dash? Let's pray. Father God, we are thankful that you've given us this gorgeous day. We thank you for the filling of your Holy Spirit and the rushing wind coming through this to remind us that you are ever present and always near. By these days to come, they're gonna need you to be greater than you ever have before. God, you are more than able to fill that need. God, I pray for this family to grab a hold of you like they never have before. Over this family, and I just thank you for what they mean to me in the name of Jesus. Amen.